Good afternoon. So I hope you won't be too disappointed. I'm not Silvers also. But I met Moya during her study, and I'm very glad to be there and to go on the European perspective that we presented this morning, and to present just a brief overview of what happens in France around short food supply chains. First, a few words of the context. So Moya told a few words about what happens in France in matter of political context. That means that, of course, short food supply chain, as in other countries, have been existing for a long time in France, especially in France. But they have been little recognized, even considered by for a long time in agriculture and by public policies. Until renewal and innovations at the beginning of 2000s, due to food scares, of course, Matco crisis, but also pushed by new societal requirements and producers' initiatives, pushed these institutions and economic actors to take them in account. So it was a break in the history. And from a participatory process, the Ministry of Agriculture in 2009 implemented a working group in order to define short food supply chain in France, but also to prepare an action plan to favor their development. From this participative process, a definition has been given. So short food supply chain is defined as 0 to 1 intermediary between producer and consumers, whatever the distance. Because in France, they didn't want to exclude producers who can be in a remote areas. That means that they have kilometers to make in order to sell their products, but also to include sales by internet. Since 2009, short food supply chain in France are promoted through different policies. First, this specific development program issued from this participative process implemented by the previous Minister of Agriculture in 4 axes, especially production and diffusion of knowledge about this short food, training producers, support to establishment, and support to organization and promotion. In this line, short food supply chain have been integrated in the agricultural census. That means that now we have statistics about short food supply chain. Short food supply chain have also been promoted through the French Rural Network, especially in a national group that I lead to capitalize what happens in territories. That means that short food supply chain have been considered as tools for local territorial development. Short food supply chain have also been promoted through national food program and modernization agricultural law. But in these different policies are, it's more incentives than financial means. But because of this definition, that means that now short food supply chain are official in France. That means a new window for development and agricultural association to work on, but also a new route for public authorities to favor local development. Even if it's only a definition, but it's a new way to a new opportunity. Short food supply chain in France, it represents 20% of farms and more than 20 modalities, even if in mines, short food supply chain are often associated with direct sales. That means that we forget the short food supply chain with one intermediary, despite they are very important in France. And of course, there are differences between products and between regions. There are some large expectations, perhaps too many expectations around short food supply chain in France, consistent with sustainable development issues. I put here an extract from the Plan Barnier. Barnier was the Minister of Agriculture who implemented the working group. And of course, short food supply chain It's a way to favor and to strengthen the link between producer and consumer, but also to make consumers more aware about food and to know more about food. Of course, short food supply chain, it's a way to make producers capt the value and to create value at the territorial level. But there are some questions, of course, and I just try to focus on what kind of research questions we address from statements, from observations made by development actors, and what are the policy implications for the moment. So first, we have still biased evaluations because either too idealistic or too critical assessment of this short food supply chain. We lack of reference. Even if they have been integrated in the agricultural statistic device, it's not enough. So that's why we develop an analysis of economic, social, and environmental performance of these chains. That means level interaction between the different dimensions and especially factors of performance at the farm level. So we participate in a first methodological approach with colleagues, and now there's a big survey in France. Plus specific samples to go deeper in the social and environmental dimensions, because it's more an exploratory dimensions. That allow to highlight and acknowledge different strategic models beyond either atypical project activists or opportunists, because there are still many clichés about farmers in short food supply chain. And these different strategic models show diverse innovations in different domains. It also allows a collective identification and assessment of new indicators of wealth inspired by social economy for short food supply chain and from short food supply chain that we can also apply to other chains or other projects. And we go on. We are associated in a European project called Glamour, in which also Damien is associated with, to make a comparative analysis between local and global food chain performance. In matter of policy issues, all the data normally should be useful to support establishment of diverse trajectories, diverse models in short food supply chains. Second point, we observe a little or slow diffusion, even exclusion of some consumers of short food supply chain. We are very interested by ordinary or low-income consumers compared to other, of course, colleagues work also on activists, but we look precisely at what happens for ordinary or low-income consumers. A national survey is in process. And this loss diffusion, it can be explained by economic reasons, but the problem is not really the price, because we make observation of price and the short food supply chain are not systematically more expensive than long chains, if you compare comparable things. That means equal quality. But the problem for low-income family, it's a problem of access. The short food supply chain directly accessible for them are often more expensive, because also there are some opportunist things. And that's why it's a problem of access. But also there are a problem of cultural breaks. That means that for most people, most ordinary or low-income people, short food supply chain equal organic, equal bobo, that means not for me. So there is like an auto-exclusion from this short food supply chain. That means that the image has to change. And media in France are quite guilty because they vehiculate a bobo image of short food supply chain. There is also confusion and disappointment of some consumers regarding short food supply chain because they think it's organic. So when they discover that it's not organic, of course they are disappointed. So the Ministry of Agriculture talked about a charter in 2010, but there was a working group, but there was no consensus about quality. Agreement on value repartition, of course, but no consensus of quality. We experiment new information and our labeling system to help people to identify short food supply chain, but above all to learn about food, taking in account their purchasing habits and without dogmatism. It's not for us a way to replace a model by another one, but to make people free and to choose. And we also experiment local food procurements in book food banks and head, along an empowerment and not a charity perspective. Third point, we observe a growing competition between short food supply chain or between this chain and long chain within territories. That means that we study a case of synergies, for instance, around slaughterhouses. And we focus on the role of intermediaries, especially artisans. And we focus also on new kind of territorial cooperatives involving producers, intermediaries, public authorities, and consumers. We also develop a critical approach of proximity food chains. In France, this term replaces the short food supply chain for logistic reasons, local employment, or environmental issues. But there is two ways to develop proximity food chains. One is the reproduction of long food chain at the local level. That means that it doesn't change anything for producers, for repartition of value, for the link between producer and consumer. Or you can strengthen the performance of short food supply chain. So that means that it also calls a frame for this chain, a claim for transparency rather than for specific practices. And we also follow the emergence of territorial food governance schemes to preserve short food supply chain specificities and manage complementarities with other chains at the level of territories. That means a new way to control, implying consumers, producers, public authorities. So just a conclusion. So first, food democracy appears as one of the integrative issues for action research, food democracy as defined by Tim Langs in the 90s. That means something that allows a progressive involvement of citizens, but also food justice, so equal access to quality food for low-income families, participatory empowering systems, and short food supply chain are only an entry point. The most interesting is the spillover effect at the level of territory. A question is raised now, it's the link between short food supply chain and the agroecological transition that is now the new mantra of the Ministry of Agriculture, and so very old fashioned in France. And for short food supply chain, there are still many breaks and limits, but perhaps the priority is to coordinate, to promote collective action between the different models, to as well perhaps to promote or to organize a clearer and harmonized frame to play, to preserve the diversity and complementarities between the different way to do agriculture and to sell products. So that means same rules, same taxes, same subsidies, and the same transparency for the different models. We have some tense relations between producers and artisans in France. And so we have this diversity to organize and to preserve. Thank you.